Hello, this is Dr. Carlo Oller, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. This video is about pseudogout. Pseudogout is a joint disease that can cause attacks of arthritis. Like gout, the condition involves the formation of crystals in the joints. But in pseudogout, the crystals are formed from a salt instead of uric acid. Pseudogout is caused by the collection of salt called calcium pyrophosphate dihydrate, or CPPD. The buildup of this salt forms crystals in the joints. This leads to attacks of joint swelling and pain in the knees, wrist, ankles, and other joints. Among older adults, pseudogout is a common cause of sudden or acute arthritis in one joint. Pseudogout mainly affects the elderly. Pseudogout is often misdiagnosed as gout, osteoarthritis, and rheumatoid arthritis. Symptoms include attacks of joint pain and fluid buildup in the joint, leading to joint swelling, chronic or long-term arthritis, and usually there's no symptoms in between the attacks. The swelling of the joint may be hot, red, swollen, it's very tender and painful. An examination of the joint fluid would show white blood cells and calcium pyrophosphate crystals. Joint x-rays may show joint damage, calcification of the cartilage, and calcium deposits in the joint spaces. Careful testing and analysis of the crystals found in the joints can help the doctors diagnose the condition. Fortunately, because most conditions involving joint pain are treated by the same medicines such as steroids and non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, an early mistaken diagnosis does not necessarily result in the wrong treatment. Treatment may involve the removal of fluid to relieve pressure within the joint. A needle is placed into the joint and fluid is removed or aspirated. Steroid injections may be helpful to treat severely inflamed joints. A course of oral steroids is sometimes used when multiple joints are inflamed. NSAIDs, or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications, may help ease painful attacks. Colchicine may also be helpful in some people. Complications: permanent joint damage can occur without treatment. You must follow up with your primary doctor, first to make sure that the diagnosis is accurate and that long-term medications and lifestyle modifications can be made. Also, to check for the development of complications and to treat them appropriately. If you have swelling of the joint, fever, chills, any systemic symptoms that is new or worsening since your initial evaluation, you should come back to the emergency department. For more videos like this video, please visit edexitvideo.com, but remember, these are educational videos and should not replace the attention or care of a medical professional. Please take a minute to like my video and to subscribe to my channel.